Here we're looking at an interactive simulation that models an adiabatic plug flow reactor in which we have recycle. So the recycle, of course, changes the feed concentration to the plug flow reactor, and it changes the concentration entering the plug flow reactor. And this is a function of how much recycle we have. If we look at what we're plotting in this simulation, we're plotting the temperature through the reactor. So starting at this point to this point. And in terms of being able to solve the equation, we're given the inlet temperature to the reactor. We're given inlet concentration to the reactor. To solve the differential equations for the plug flow reactor, the mass balances and the energy balances, we actually need the value of T0. But T0 depends on what T final is. That depends on how much conversion takes place in the plug flow reactor. So the way we're going to solve it here is we're going to guess T0. So here you have the ability, when you're using a simulation, to guess the value of T0. And then that will allow us to solve the differential equations to get T final. I guess T0. I'm going to calculate T final. You say, what value of T initial does this correspond to, such that we know T initial, we can back calculate a T0 that would give us a combination of T initial plus T final, taking into account their volumetric flow rates. And so that's what this slider does, and then it's displayed here. So the circle, the green circle, corresponds to the value of T initial that we picked in this top slider, 300 Kelvin. And then we're going to adjust the entrance temperature to the plug flow reactor until this arrow will move up and down until it lines up with our known value for T in, the inlet temperature. For the case of low recycle ratio, notice there's a fairly large temperature change in the plug flow reactor. And then T0 is much higher than inlet temperature, 300 Kelvin here, and it's 417 here. If we have a higher recycle ratio, notice there's not much change in reactors, a different inlet temperature. Now the T0 value is much lower. We're approaching more like a CSTR. The temperature increases only from 371 to about 374 Kelvin, whereas on the left, temperature increases almost 120 degrees. And notice, when we guess T0, we will also calculate our corresponding reactant concentration. Let's call it C0 for our reactant. That corresponds to that temperature because this is an adiabatic system. There's a unique relation between conversion and temperature. So there's a possibility to have more than one solution. In other words, more than one value of T0 that will allow us to solve the equations. Once we have feedback, like recycle, then the same kind of behavior we have observed in CSTRs, we have the potential for multiple solutions. So now let's go and look at the interactive simulation. I've given the location here on the Wolfram site, and let's look at its behavior. Okay, so here's the interactive simulation on the Wolfram site, and we can vary the feed temperature. And so you can see the green circle is going to move. Can vary the recycle ratio. And as the recycle ratio gets higher, you notice the gradient through the plug flow reactor is much smaller because of so much recycle. And then we vary this guess temperature to get the correct answer. So when we line up the arrow for the calculated T, and I can move it a little more controlled manner. So that's pretty close. 419 is the temperature entering the reactor. That's T0. The inlet temperature of the system is 291. And then, of course, it solves for the outlet temperature from the system. It looks like it's about 435. So one thing that's possible, and let's look at a condition where I already know this is going to happen. So if I have the feed temperature, and it happens at a number of conditions, but let's look at solving for the case where we have recycle ratio of 19 and we have a feed temperature of 300 Kelvin. So I'm going to vary T0, and right about there, we're pretty close, 301, so we can get it obviously closer, but that's close enough to say at 410, and looks like 411 we're right on. So 411 then is the correct temperature for T0. But the question is there another temperature? And so if I start lowering this, well, I'm getting further away from the, but now I'm starting to get closer, and it looks like indeed there's another solution at 310 for T0. So not much of a temperature increase, the exit reactor, which means very low conversion. So here's the case. We have multiple solutions in this plug flow reactor. And this corresponds to the fact we have feedback. And so you can use this to look at different conditions, and you're basically doing the iterative solution by moving the guess temperature.